Andrew Davis has asked how to paint the armour and cloth of the Sons of Jormungandr. So in today's video, we're going to show you how to do that. Now, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've gone Mechanica Standard Grey, which is perfect, especially when doing those black areas. We're going to start by using a Bad in Black for all the armour. We're then going to chip up the armour using a little bit of lead belcher. We're then going to paint the cloth using Avalanche Sunset. We'll then shade the cloth using Cassandra Yellow, and then we'll highlight the cloth using Screaming Skull. But first of all, let's get onto those black armour details. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to get a dollop or two off a Bad in Black, and then I'm going to add a couple of paintbrushes of water. So you're probably looking at like three parts water to one part black. So it's nice and runny. And what we're going to do then, get our brush to a nice point, we're going to start actually applying it to the armour details. Now, because we've thinned it down, what you'll get is a lot of that Mechanica Standard Grey showing through, so you'll get a nice natural highlight for most of the armour details. In the next stage, we'll be doing some chipping, but for most of it, it gives it a nice, crisp highlight, as you can see here. With the black now dry, we're going to move on to using lead belcher, and what we're going to do here is start applying chipping to the armour panels. So this is things like his chest armour and his shoulder pads and stuff. Things like his gloves and boots, they're more leather, so you just leave them as they are. So what you're doing is just going around some of the edges and just stabbing with your brush. In some places, like on the panel here, what I might just do is just do a little couple of little dots as well, moving in little flicks, like so, just to look like really battered effects on the armour. With the chipping now done, we're going to move on to painting the yellow of the cloth. So for this, we'll be using Avalanche Sunset. I'm just going to move them around to the back because there's a lot more areas you can see. I'm just going to do a couple of thin coats of this. And that's the trousers and the sleeves you'll need to do these on. With the cloth areas now base coated, we're going to start applying a shade of Cassandra Yellow to this area. So just, you only need to do really one shade. And just make sure you, if it does pull in the recesses, you soak it with your brush. With the shade dry, we're just going to finish off by doing a highlight of Screaming Skull. So any like raised areas or bits of cloth that are just sticking out, let's do a little edge highlight of Screaming Skull. With the highlight now done, the cloth and armour of the Son of Jormungandr is completed. Well, I hope you found that useful, Andrew. Keep sending those requests in, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.